Right now on Secrets of Louisville Chefs, a local bar reinvents itself with old school Kentucky cooking.
It's really good.
We're going out to eat and inside the kitchen at the Monkey Wrench.
I love the Monkey Wrench.
The Monkey Wrench chef is revealing the secrets to his most popular dishes.
Giving away my trade secrets here. Cast iron fried chicken, chicken livers, and smoked bison meatloaf.
And the best seller of all, the Monkey Wrench.
Butter beans. It's a real hearty meal. It's delicious. And we'll show you how we make them from start to finish.
It's Kentucky cooking at its finest. And the secrets to doing it yourself as we go behind the scenes at the Monkey Wrench right now on Secrets of Louisville Chef.
Learn something new every day.
Hi everybody, Kevin Harned with you with a country cooking edition of Secrets this time at a place in the Highlands that had been known for live music and drinks. Nowadays, the Monkey Wrench is known for its Southern style food.
It is an entirely new Monkey Wrench.
Southern style restaurant that's affordable.
New genre of food that we're calling contemporary hillbilly.
It was very good.
Oh, it's a great place.
We've taken a place that truly used to be a dive bar, you know, a bar for concerts, a venue kind of establishment, and turned it into strictly a food environment.
It's awesome. The food was great. It really was.
More so focused on food, more so than the early days when we were just kind of an outlet for artists and musicians.
Monkey Wrench owner Denny Humphrey knows a thing or two about hillbilly food and drink, for that matter.
I'm from Louisville, but my roots tie to Hardin County, and I'm from a bloodline of bootleggers.
Denny grew up with country cooking, as did chef Dustin Staggers. But Dustin is putting some new twist on the Southern classics.
Classic comfort food that if you grew up in Kentucky, your grandmother probably made, and we've adopted it to modern style.
Dustin is originally from Florida, but he feels right at home here in Kentucky.
I always tell people I moved 900 miles north to cook Southern food, which is kind of funny. But I grew up loving Southern food myself personally, so it was easy to come here and adopt some of the flavors and philosophies of this city and put it in my cuisine.
Now at the Monkey Wrench, Dustin is the king of the country kitchen.
I like that. King of the country kitchen. I like that. That's solid.
If it's Southern food, Dustin cooks it. Fried chicken, chicken livers.
I had the po' boy. It was excellent.
We actually had the blue crab hush puppies too, and they were really good.
There's meatloaf that's cooked on the smoker, and of course, butter beans.
Butter beans. I love butter beans. Butter beans and cornbread became a staple in Kentucky. Just something that people would eat for breakfast, dinner, lunch, brunch. It didn't really matter. Grandmas would make butter beans for their kids. And truly, it's our best-selling dish. It's what we sell the most of.
And today, Chef Dustin is revealing his secrets to what makes them so popular.
Truly, the secret to our butter beans, we use Gatton Farms Country Ham. Fathers, they've been around for 130 years making country hams. Their ham is incredible. We take the ham bones and some bits of ham and make a ham stock, essentially. And then we cook our butter beans in there for about 45 minutes to an hour, cool them down.
You can cook the beans in advance and then warm them up in stock when you're ready to eat.
Strangely, you can actually even freeze butter beans. Freeze them and then bring them back up to temperature if you want to make them at a later date. We're gonna add a little bit of the butter beans. We're gonna add some fresh Father's Country ham bits. Next, we're gonna add a little bit of clarified butter. We're gonna add a little bit more vegetable stock just to loosen it up just a little bit. We're gonna let that simmer down and add a little bit of kosher salt and ground black pepper.
A minute later, and they're ready.
To finish this dish, we're gonna take some of our house cornbread, put it in a bowl. It's pretty delicious. We take some of the pork belly fat that we use to make our bacons, reduce it down into a lard. Some Kenny's white cheddar cheese and some green onions to make our cornbread. It's great. We're gonna add our finished butter beans. Essentially wanna be able to break the cornbread up into the butter beans. Our sweetness from the cornbread, you get saltiness from the beans and the ham.
The garnish is a couple leaves from a stalk of celery.
They add a totally different element and note to the dish.
Butter beans. It doesn't get any more Kentucky than that, and it doesn't get any more Southern than with chicken livers.
They have some of the best here in town, and
the Monkey Wrench.
Chicken livers, without question, my favorite thing on the menu. Our chicken livers are the best in town, I say that unequivocally. People either love them or hate them, and there's very few places in this town that you can go get chicken livers that aren't overbreaded. We take some Marksberry Farm chicken livers, we're taking some regular sifted all-purpose flour, we're gonna add some Weizenberger cornmeal to the mix, we're gonna add a little bit of onion powder, gonna add a little bit of garlic powder, then we're gonna add a little bit of kosher salt, just with a little mix of ground black pepper in it. We're gonna take three or four gorgeous chicken livers.
Those get dredged in the flour mixture.
You see, we have a very light coating on them.
Here's where it can get a little bit dangerous.
When we cook them in a cast iron pan, as we do here, the bleeding out of the livers mixed with the hot oil can sometimes create a volatile environment, let's say, in the kitchen. We've all been burned quite a few times by these livers. Back of the head, arm, neck. All right, we're gonna take these finished livers out of the oil. We're gonna put down some caramelized Vidalia onions right in the middle of the plate. We're gonna add the finished chicken livers on top. Jose's the king of the chicken liver stack. We're gonna add some red eye gravy that we make in-house. Finish it off with some hot pepper relish, which is some Grateful Greens micro basil. And there's your chicken livers. They look delicious.
And believe me, if you're a fan of chicken livers like me, they taste delicious too. Head on down to the Monkey Wrench and see for yourself.
It was really awesome. It was really awesome.
And check this out. It's meatloaf cooked on a smoker.
This is definitely not your grandmother's meatloaf.
The chef will share his secrets to that coming up.
Giving away my trade secrets here.
Plus, the famous Monkey Wrench fried chicken and the secrets to doing it yourself when the Secrets of Louisville Chefs returns. Kevin Harnett back with you at the Monkey Wrench, where they're putting a new twist on old school Southern food. The Monkey Wrench is just down the road from the old Lynn's Paradise Cafe, which closed in 2013. Since then, folks around here have been starving for another restaurant with hearty Kentucky-style food, and now they've got it.
Oh, it's a good atmosphere. We've had a good time. We're laughing it up, having a good meal. Delicious.
Wide array of choices, and, so let's have a good time.
It was really great. We're going to come back.
Food wasn't always the focus here. It used to be more about the bar scene. All of that changed when Monkey Wrench owner Denny Humphrey met Dustin Staggers, who had been the chef at 60 West Bistro.
With the addition of Mr. Staggers, we kind of went to the next level. I approached him and he asked me a simple question. He said, "What are you thinking food-wise?" And I said, "Straight Kentucky." And his statement was, "Cast iron skillet." And I think I said, "Mutton." And then he said, "Butter beans." Yeah, it was a match made in heaven.
Chef Dustin has been cooking his whole life, first out of necessity.
All self-taught, lots of Iron Chef and cookbooks.
Then he cooked for fun.
Kind of started as a tailgate chef, which is not normal for most people that start in this business.
That was in Tampa, Florida, in the parking lot of Buccaneer football games.
Diehard Buccaneers fan. We threw some of the most elaborate tailgates known to man. A couple hundred people, you know, six or eight smokers, and that's kind of how I began cooking.
And still today, as executive chef at the Monkey Wrench, he still relies heavily on his smoker.
And we smoke rabbits, lambs, we make our own bacon in-house, chickens, turkeys for hot browns. We're willing to put anything on the smoker. Here we have some of our house-smoked pork belly. We use that for our bacon. We use it to top hot brown soups. We use it for a multitude of things in the restaurant. Here we have some rabbit haunches that we use for making our burgoo.
It's really good.
In the back right here, we have some of our mutton legs for our barbecue raspberry mutton dish. People love this. It doesn't get any more country than mutton.
Dustin even makes meatloaf on the smoker.
This is definitely not your grandmother's meatloaf.
You can do it the same way at home. Learn the secrets.
Well, we're gonna take 5 pounds of Kentucky bison. We're gonna add some of our house stewed tomatoes in there. We're gonna take some Trifecta barbecue sauce. It's a barbecue sauce made by a regular at this bar, a local guy, he's a great guy. Some charred green onions. We take green onions, coat them in olive oil and salt and pepper. put them over an open flame and burn them a little bit. Just the flavor alone of something like a green onion changes entirely when you put a little bit of olive oil on it and char it up in the oven. A little bit of crushed red pepper, some cumin, of course some kosher salt. The secret to everything that we do here, some of our house smoked pork belly, bacon for most people. We use it on our burgers. We use it in a lot of things that we make here, but it's the key to the secret to this, this delicious meatloaf we have. A little bit of panko.
The panko acts as a binder, along with a fresh egg.
And mix it all up.
This is when it's actually okay to play with your food.
Oh, that's the best part about cooking, is playing with your food. That's why kitchen people love to be kitchen people. Get that all mixed in there nice and good. I'm gonna put this in a, this case, a little shallow hotel pan, form it into a loaf.
Now, usually this would go into the oven, but at the Monkey Wrench, it goes onto the smoker.
We're gonna take this and smoke it in our smoker for about 45 minutes. Right here we have some of our smoked bison meatloaf. We'll get a little bit of oaky flavor and a little bit of hickory flavor, and the finished product is nice and moist and delectable. We'll take our full smoked bison meatloaf. You can see it's got a nice redness. It's nice and done. It looks beautiful, actually. We'll take this, cut a few slices, put it in a hot pan, and finish it in the oven. We're gonna then take some of our trifecta barbecue sauce again, put it on the plate, take our loaves, lay them out. We finish it off with a little bit of Grateful Greens micro basil, and that's a dish. Smoked bison meatloaf.
It was very good, very satisfied.
One thing's for sure, you don't leave the Monkey Wrench hungry. In fact, they're open for dinner every night except for Mondays, and they offer a Kentucky-style Sunday brunch.
It's very country, southern, classic breakfast.
And it's live bluegrass music.
Stay with us, because up next, it's another staple of Kentucky cooking.
You can't serve hillbilly food without fried chicken.
And they do it a little different here than most places. We'll show you how when we come back with more Secrets of Louisville Chefs right here from the Monkey Wrench. Hi, everybody, and welcome back to Secrets of Louisville Chefs. I'm Kevin Harned. This is the show that takes you out to eat behind the scenes and into the kitchens of your favorite local restaurants. If you're a fan of country cooking, this is a place that's sure to make your list of favorites. We're in the Highlands at the Monkey Wrench.
I love the Monkey Wrench.
We're not making the food pretentious, but we're making it a little different than your grandma would have served, but still that down-home comfort that you're looking for when most people sit down to eat.
It's bluegrass food paired with live bluegrass music. And there's plenty of bluegrass brew to go with it all.
So I really like that they have the local beer, you know, selection that you can mix in with what you're eating.
So what's in a name? Why the Monkey Wrench? Well, the owner's original idea was to open a bar in a garage. Then this property came available, and Denny Humphrey jumped right on in.
We found an old Monkey Wrench behind one of the walls, and I just kind of looked at my partner, and he said, well, we like the name, we're going to stick with it.
The Monkey Wrench also happens to be the name of a quilt pattern, which is now the restaurant's logo. As far as the food is concerned, well, it's all the southern classics, from butter beans and cornbread to cast iron skillet fried chicken.
You can't serve hillbilly food without fried chicken. It's one of my favorite things on earth, and we've taken, once again, your grandma's cast iron chicken and, you know, made it modern. Made it not pretentious, but made it modern and delicious. Our secret here truly is Kentucky sorghum and a cast iron pan. We're gonna take a breast and a drumstick of some Marksberry Farm chicken. We're gonna take just some basic sifted flour. Gonna add a little bit of onion powder, a little bit of garlic powder, a little bit of salt and pepper.
He mixes that together and then begins the breading process.
We're gonna then take our breast and our drumstick of chicken. We're gonna dredge it in butter. Can't be any food that's dredged in butter. I like the bind that butter provides a lot better, and the flavor is, it's butter compared to egg wash. Lightly dredge them in this flour. Make sure we get it coated all over. Want to get it on there nice and tight. All right, we're going to take our cut pieces, nicely dredged.
And that's not oil in that pan. Chef Dustin goes old school, frying his chicken in lard.
The lard cooking the fried chicken as opposed to peanut oil or blended oil that you get in the fryer, the flavor difference is, you could put two chicken dishes next to each other and taste the difference immediately. All right, we're gonna take our chicken, perfect golden brown.
It's always tasty, but never served in the same way, because at the Monkey Wrench, no two plates are alike.
We like not using traditional plates. It's great. We don't have any white plates that we serve anything on, and none of our plates are identical to any other plates that we have. Use some of our fire-roasted banana pepper aioli. We take banana peppers, same way we do the scallions. We cook them over an open flame, burn them and char them, cut them up into small bits, mix them with some mayonnaise and some other fresh herbs. Put our chicken, drumstick. We're gonna coat it with some Kentucky sorghum. We have the sorghum for true, just deep sweetness. We have the banana pepper aioli to add a little bit of heat. And then we're gonna take this elderberry jam, which is gonna add a little bit of citrus and a little bit more sweetness, a little bit deeper sweetness.
And it gets even better with the Monkey Wrench's house-made cornbread.
Then we're gonna finish it again with some Grateful Greens micro basil. And magic, voila. Cast iron fried chicken.
Fried chicken that's even better than Grandma used to make. It might sound hard to believe, but come on down to the Monkey Wrench and taste it for yourself.
And let us know what you think. You can find us on Facebook, Twitter, and always on our website, where you'll find a complete restaurant guide and all the recipes. That's newlocaltv.com. I'm Kevin Harnett, and for all of us at B&B Productions, we'll see you next time on Secrets of Louisville Chefs.